Hi chaps, welcome to another part of the Project KH. In the previous video, if you've watched the previous one, we actually took the top end apart, found a couple of issues, and I've just basically run this basically by the owner of the bike. So anyway, we're progressing, we're moving on, we'll move onwards, and yeah, so let's get into the job. So we need, what we'll do, right, I'm going to start and think me undoing. Okay, now electrics are coming with us, so and we do have, yeah, they actually, I'm just going to screw back in a few threads for a minute. Don't want it falling out. I do need it out there because I want to no, we're not actually vapor blasting that part, that's just going for polishing. Right, we'll get it out of the way. Let that oil drain. Okay, so yeah, just looking at stuff here, yeah, that's all. So, right. Why oh why? Do we have what looks like gearbox oil? Should we have gearbox oil in this side? Not pulled one of these apart before. KH motor. So we're gonna have a rag. Looking at the shape of the crankcases there, I don't know whether that should have. But to me, look, any reason why there should be oil in there. But it's lathered with it. We see what came out there. So, I'm sure it will all become apparent, but see, just have another look at this jenny colour. Perhaps it does. But then you would think there would be a cover to stop oil being able to get out onto the points. A seal of some description. We've definitely got oil inside here. Anyway, we'll have a look. We'll go a bit further. I'm sure it will all become apparent. Right. So, that looks like that will just, with the, you just see the crank seal at the back of there, as will this. So, obviously anything now that is bridging the two cases, i.e. holding them together, is obviously going to need to be removed. So, oh, the amount I've found on this bike that's not tight. No, he's not tight either. I'll just turn that one in as well. Yeah, well, absolutely. You know, I hate it. It makes you wonder what some people think is a acceptable level of tightness. The little Bendix that pushes the clutch push rod. Obviously it bridges the two halves of the cases, so if the case is to split, we need to remove that from the issue. In fact, I want to put that in with the remaining engine parts. So, okay, we'll turn around this side now. And I think what really is quite important here is that we very, very carefully remove all the oil injection pipes. So, to start with, I think we remove, I don't know whether I can get that oil pump out. See, is that, I'm not sure whether that was two stroke oil that's come through, but it was running okay on this cylinder. This is the, I don't know, we're surmising too much at the minute, so. On my life, I have not touched any of this before. This is just unbelievable amount of tightness. Right, get this through. All needs to be bled when it goes back on. Okay, I'll get access to this screw in here. Oh, be nice if that was tight too. Wow. Somebody definitely does not believe in tightening stuff up. Anyway, there we go. So we have to get that little banjo bolt out of the way. Is that an A310? Honestly, I can't believe I'm gonna just nip that back up there like that. It's actually quite frightening what's not been tight on this bike. It really has been a little bit oh my god. Yeah, it really has. Right, so what have we got? 14s perhaps. At least they had a degree of torque on them. So my thinking is I'm just gonna put that back in there like that for the minute. Take that out, complete with its sealing washer. Let's put it straight back in. Just remove the banjos. The banjo bolts and Kawasaki. Oh, we've actually got an upper and a lower washer on that one. Okay, so. Oh, that was tight though. Wow. Oh, well, I've got one and another. Fantastic. Right, just for the minute, I'm going to take the little screws out of there and see if we can thread this whole I'm going to say quite delicate oil injection and oil pump. So a little flat there for the drive, for the oil pump drive. Okay, so this is just going to go in the parts tray to be kept away from everything else and not stressing on these plastic pipes at all. Okay, so these go with it. Right, now that gives us access to the clutch cover that's kind of made up a bit of Phillips and a bit of Phillips's. Is that the one I did before? Let's have a look at that one. Oh, look at that. Look at that one. Fantastic. Never mind. They will go back differently. Okay, let's see. A bit. They had a bit on that one. And perhaps that one was this one. Yeah, a bit on that one. So this is where I use the cardboard for, as you can see. They could do with being slightly longer than bolts, I think. But anyway, I'm not criticising, I'm just, you know, making observations. Okay. Yeah, using the cardboard on the bench, I mean, you know, it soaks it up and gives us a gasket's moving off there, so we're going to put that with the oil pump. Right, okay. There we go. Right, okay. Now, for this particular, I'm just going to get a little tub. A little tub. Top off an aerosol. Keeps all them particular bolts in one place. So let's have a look. How easy or how difficult am I completely out? I think we are. Now there's one there. How did I not see that one? Oh, well, we weren't tight anyway. Hiding behind the kickstart shaft. Right, so in the tub with others. Right, my friendly little rubber hammer. You can hear the sound change. Dowel on there and kickstart shaft. Just a bit of a bind on the kickstart shaft. There we go. Rubber hammer, we've got no damage. We're not sticking screwdrivers in everywhere. Right. Even when you think you're I wonder whether there's an issue with that. Whether we have to. Not sure. I'm not going stupidly tight. I'm just going to rotate that and see whether that wants us to just rotate a little bit. To allow. I wouldn't have thought so. Okay. Yeah, you drain the oil, but it's there's always oil in it. You know, from that's what I say why we use the cardboard. She's given up on us. Okay, there we go. Okay, so here we see the oil pump drive gear off the end of the crank. You know, I might just let that drain onto the cardboard and we'll just chuck the cardboard. Okay, I've got some old rags now, so I'm just gonna move on notes, tools over there, etc. I'm just going to let that sit in an old rack for a minute. Saved for the purpose. Okay, so now we can see. Somebody's definitely been in here. We've got new lock washers. And somebody's definitely been in here before. Anyway, maybe if we can just lift that up and add. To see just a visual in here, that's the right, somebody's definitely been on there anyway, but anyway, okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to take the clutch off and eight. Socket, 8mm socket. They don't need to be tight, they're not over tight these, which, but again, they're under a constant spring pressure, and you know, they're only a little use a Phillips from here. Okay. For a second. Yeah, so I think this engine could tell us some tales. I think it's been one of them engines that's been stood for a long time, personally. Generally you find crank webs that are usual good old telltale of a time with no lubricant. I mean, there's not a lot in there to start with, even last time it ran, never mind something that's been stood for months on end. So oh my god, have a look here now. Can you see that? See the clutch plates there, and the tabs of the clutch plates are broke there. Hope the camera's picking that up. They're missing there. So I've got some tabs broken off the clutch plates. Let's take them out and have a look. Okay. First one out, there's the little lifter. Okay. Second one, metal plate, fiber plate, and again we'll have a metal plate with a spring. So I'm going to pull that back and pull that exactly where it came out, which is like that. At that point, so now we've got another metal and another fiber, and then we're about at the, here we go, another spring, so another metal and another fiber. Now what we got, oh my word, another spring. Ah, that's interesting. So we've got the plate with a tab broke. I suppose on the face of it, it's actually that critical, but it just proves to us, another spring in there actually, it just proves to us that you really don't know something until, I'm gonna check the actual sequence of the installation of them springs in the online on a exactly where they should be, but it just proves to us that, you know, you get a degree of, well, would you have fitted that, refitted that? I don't suppose on the face of it, it's, I've seen worse things happen, but then having said that, then no, it really should have had a new set of clutch plates. But anyway, clutch in there with its springs. So now the springs go with it. Okay, so we're now down to primary gears. We soaked up a bit of this mess. So, now, there is a lock washer on that nut, as is, there's a lock washer on that nut. Let me just see that for a second. I'll just sit there for a minute. Yeah, it is tight, so fine. Okay. I always wondered why the KH had such big rear sprocket, which meaning that obviously a big rear sprocket means you're trying to gear the thing down. So, but you can see one of the reasons there, the size of the crankshaft primary drive. Normally we've only got a very small, so the actual gearbox is spinning quite fast in this you know, in this engine. The reduction, I mean, although the reduction is vast, but like on the 250 amps, that sort of stuff, you generally only get a tiny little primary gear on the end of the crank and a lot bigger. So anyway, the position of the shafts dictated, and I suppose the depth and whatever anyway, but that's why the gearbox must spin quite fast in this. So you've got to reduce it down at the back wheel, just to, you can actually see the size of the primary gears. So anyway, right, from here we need I'm just going to give that lock tab is back. Just knock the tab back on the lock tab there. So, what do you think that is? A 19. It is. Now, what I'm going to have to do, I think, is buzz gun, which means me firing my compressor up. Obviously the sound will be, unless this in, we don't need to fire the compressor up. Oh my God. Never mind. We don't have to stop the video. We just keep going. Right, we can take the clutch hub off. Noting exactly what we've got, a little lock washer there, noting exactly what we have. So next in line is this big washer that goes there, and then I think we can slide off. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to put that back like that and like that, and put a cable tie through it. Take this, and it went that way. Okay, and there's actually a washer there, and that's going to go like that. Okay, so we now know, I'm just going to get a cable tie, be out of the video shot for a minute, just 2 minutes. right? We lose nothing. Okay, and it's in order. Okay. He just helps. I mean, we don't know how long it's going to be, and you know, if you're anything like me, I forget where I live sometimes. Never mind. Never mind inside of an engine. Okay, moving on. So now we have the gear selector. So, as we can see, the gear selector rotates the drum. That shaft, obviously, see it trying to rotate the drum just there. Okay, so looking at that, generally what happens is you can lift the teeth away, and there you go, she'll just come off. So through the seal on the other side. Wow, do you reckon they could have made that any longer? Wow, I don't think I've seen one longer than that, even in a 1000cc bike or whatever. But anyway, there we go. So we've just got a little spring-loaded set of ratchety pull fingers, if you like, that pull, rotate, and move the drum round. In a little, we'll come to it in a second. Right. So what we now have, with the oil flowing around, being thrown around by the primary gears, there's a little catch to this bearing on the end of the output shaft. A little catch. Quite clever, quite simple, and very effective. Just catches the oil as it's going around and ducts it into the bearing. So so there we go. Okay. Let's just have a look at that. Thank God that was tight, eh? Not overly, but thank God it was tight. Okay, so there it is. There's our little catch. Catches the oil being thrown around everywhere and puts it through the centre, straight into the centre of the shaft. I presume there's going to be holes all the way along the shaft, and that oil will just come out between the gears on the shaft. So we're going to put that in with our clutch hub. Again, splitting the cases, you can see the split line all the way across. Now, what's in here to actually pull the cases apart, I don't need to remove. I don't think I need to remove anyway. The selector drum, that's a selector shaft just behind there. That'll be where the forks slide along the shaft in there. Is there perhaps another one behind there? So, yeah, so my visual on it is, so I'm just, again, I'm not tightening this up to any, I just want to turn it, and it's just a little bit above you turning it with your fingers, so. Right, okay. So the kickstart mechanism is internal, as is the spring, because it's now turning the shaft, which would be turning the crank had the primary drive been on, done internally. Again, on some Yamahas you get the little gear outside of here, so it's kind of this side, but this is actually inside. So, and I'm fighting against an aggressive spring there, to be fair. So now I would say that's the stop for the spring. At this point I'm not sure whether I need to be taking that out yet or not, but, and it obviously hits a stop somewhere there, so there's a preload on that. As we come to separate them cases, I think we may have to just perhaps take some preload off. I think it's there. I think what I'm going to do with this one, I'm just going to, no, that won't go yet. Yeah, as we, in fact, what I'm going to do, I'm just going to check online with that. So, if in doubt, check. Okay, I think that has reached a good part for us to stop this particular one, and we'll pick it up. I'm going to clean all this oil up, and we'll pick it up when we know a little bit more of how this kickstart, preload, etc., all comes apart. Okay. Again, thanks for watching. Hit the like and subscribe if you like, and we'll catch you on the next one. Project KH. Thank you very much.